Hello everyone, my name is Pierre Perrault and today I will present our work on covariance adapting algorithm for semi-bandits with application to sparse outcomes. So this is a joint work with Vianney Perchet and Michel Valco. So in this work we study stochastic combinatorial semi-bandits and provide new algorithms that are adapted to correlation data leading to probably faster learning. In particular, we prove new lower bounds and upper bounds and apply also our results for sparse outcomes, which has application in many recommender systems. So we consider an unknown process of random vector XT, this IID in Rn. And at each round, the agent needs to choose a super arm AT, also called action, that belongs to an action set capital A, and gets the feedback, the semi-bandit feedback corresponding to that action. And the goal is to minimize the regret, which is defined as the cumulative sum of the expecting gap between an optimal policy playing always the optimal action A star and the policy AT that choose AT at each round. So here the unknown parameter mu star is the expectation of the random vector. And this problem has many variants where depending on the assumption you have on this random process of outcomes. And in most of the relevant work, we have the minimum requirements on the process, that is each component is sub-Gaussian. So without further assumption, we have those upper and lower bound. This was obtained by Vetten in 2015. So here M is the maximum size of an action, and delta is the minimum gap, positive gap between two actions. So you have a matching upper bound that is by the algorithm CUCB. In contrast, when you have more assumption on the family, you can get more tighter upper bound. So in the case you know that the outcomes are independent, then Degen and Perchet proved this upper bound with a polylogarithmic factor in front of the regret. And Combe proved this lower bound. So this is matching up to this polylogarithmic factor. And Degen also proved an interpolating behavior between those two bounds, considering a sub-Gaussian assumption on the outcomes with a known sub-Gaussian matrix, and they use the maximum correlation coefficient gamma with respect to this matrix to express the lower bounds and the upper bounds. And the main open question that is left by Degen and Perchet was whether the assumption that the sub-Gaussian matrix is known could be removed, or at least replaced by some tighter quantity, that is the covariance matrix itself, that is tighter than the sub-Gaussian matrix. And whether this would be possible also to learn the covariance matrix online. This would be very helpful because we would not need anymore to assume that we have a known covariance quantity. So this is what we assume, this is what we have in this paper. So for this, we assume the following sub-exponential type assumption on the outcomes. And you can see this is actually a bound on the MGF that has the covariance appearing there. So we assume the covariance is unknown, and through this assumption, we want to use this covariance to express our bonds with respect to it. So we also have to learn this covariance because it's unknown. So this assumption is satisfied by Gaussian outcomes and also bounded outcomes. So this is generally, those assumptions are generally mild. So it's not a big assumption to have that this inequality holds. So as I said, sigma star is a tighter quantity than the sub-Gaussian matrix with respect to the positive semi-definite order. So this means that making this matrix appearing in the regret bound is better than the usual sub-Gaussian matrix. So in this bound, we have an intuition for the dimension one, which reduced to a Bernstein MGF bound, the classical one. So we first beginning with a lower bound that is improving on the lower bound of Degen and Perche, because here we have the whole covariance matrix coefficients that appears instead of just a summarizing quantity gamma, and the proof uses the same method. So here we consider the n over m path problem with Gaussian outcomes, and this reduces to a classical multi-embedded problem, and we apply Lyer-Robin bounds. So our goal is to build an algorithm that is matching this lower bound. So for this, our approach is called efficient sampling combinatorial bandit with covariance estimates. So first we build a UCB on the covariance, and then we use this UCB to build a confidence region around the empirical mean. So here is the empirical covariance, and this is the empirical mean vector. And this region is defined for every action, and actually you already have an intuition that it is similar to Bernstein confidence intervals but instead of the covariance, the empirical variance, we have a covariance term that appears. Then with this region, the agent just choose AT that is maximizing this bilinear programming. So with this approach, we already have some positive points, that is that we don't need any sub-Gaussian matrix to build the confidence region. We just have the covariance and estimate the covariance estimate, and just playing it to build the region. So this is a good point. The bad point is that even if the covariance is not diagonal, we have an axis-aligned confidence region. So this might be counterintuitive, but we will see after that this is to make the easier the analysis. So the regret bound for this algorithm is as follows. So as we can see, up to a polylogarithmic factor in M, we are matching the lower bound. And I have to emphasize that this is for small delta. So this is because of the sub-exponential assumption and because of the estimation of the covariance that brings second order errors. But here we just print the first order error. So this is for small delta. So the analysis is relying on covering arguments rather than Laplace method. So this is because Laplace methods works well for sub-Gaussian outcomes, but in our case, for this is harder to deal with sub-exponential. So we rather use a covering argument, and also for because the covariance estimation is hard to deal with Laplace method, and the covering argument is much easier to deal with an axis-aligned region. So this is why we we use this diagonal matrix instead of sigma star. So we also provide an application to sparse outcomes. So here we assume that the outcomes are sparse. So for example, it can represent a payment vector of an user that just wants to buy S items. And we also assume bounded outcomes. So in this case, we can apply the same analysis as previously, mostly the same with some variation. But since we have that the outcomes are bounded, we fall into our previous assumption. So all the previous analysis works. So in this particular case, we also have some special extra assumption on the outcomes, that is that it is sparse. So for the lower bound, this is a bit different than the previous analysis, and we can't rely on Lie Robin. So instead, we rely on Lie and Graves to have this this lower bound. And for the upper bound, we consider a slightly different confidence region that depends on this quantity, that is a CB on this expectation. And actually, this quantity replaces the covariance quantity. And you can notice that thanks to this assumption, the sum of this mu I sums to S. So for this region, applying the same analysis gets this kind of upper bound. So we provide also some experiments. So we compare our algorithm ESCBC against CUCBV and CUCBKL, that are the CUCB framework with empirical Bernstein confidence interval or KL-based confidence intervals. So this comparison is on a problem of maximum assortment. So we can see that our approach is it's much better than those two previous state-of-the-art algorithms. Notice that we did not compare to OLS UCB of Degen and Percher because their implementation is inefficient to apply with a great combinatorial actions. Notice that our approach is also inefficient, but we provide in the paper an efficient implementation that only brings a logarithmic factor in the regret. So this experiment shows our algorithm with this implementation. So thank you for your attention, and see you at the conference.